Nicely feature two lady drivers in competition.
And Wayne Roush is going to be the test puller in tonight's class. Here's his pull in a beautiful 1923 Model T.
Test puller is kind of a unique position. That is the pull they determine whether or not the sled is set. The test puller will be the one who actually determines when this event will start.
So Wayne Roush is going to set the field, and we'll be back from San Jose, California in just a moment.
Join Bob Jenkins and Larry Neuber for all the latest news and highlights on ESPN Speed Week. Friday nights at 7:30 Eastern on ESPN.
And welcome back to Spartan Stadium in San Jose, California. I'm Richard Bleek. I'm going to be topside. Army Armstrong's going to be down trackside. We're just about ready to get underway with tonight's pull. As a matter of fact, the test pull has been made, Army.
Yeah, Wayne Roush out of Dublin, Ohio, drew that test pull position, turned it down. He'll come back later in the field.
So George Gielish is going to be our first car coming out of the line. George is driving one of the California cars, and they're funny bodies on it.
Yeah, they call them funny cars. This particular body style is not that popular back east. However, the California boys have really picked up on it. Has some tremendous-looking equipment.
And the car looks good. It's the Wanderer is what he calls it, but it does not look like he's going to get a lot of distance out of this pull.
No, the engine kind of leaned out on him. You notice the flames going away in him a little bit. The flagman runs out and stops him right there. He goes about, a 219.
219, 2 inches. Not a great pull. It's not going to win tonight, but the guy coming to the line next does have a shot to win tonight. And there's a story here. Bill Bonkoski out of Glendale, Arizona, driving good and plenty, and his daughter's running tonight, too.
Yeah, father and daughter combination. Now, Dad drew the number one spot, so that's an advantage for the daughter. She gets an opportunity to watch him pull, and then she'll go back and make some chassis adjustments according to his run.
Bill off to a good start, 38 years old, out of Glendale, Arizona. The crowd is getting into this pull as you see the smoke coming out of the engine. That's his daughter, Kathy. She's going to be running a little bit later on. He shuts her down after a distance of 224 and 4 inches. Bill Bonkoski in the good and plenty car. His daughter's going over to him. Let's send it down to Army Armstrong, who's going to find out what happened on the pull with Bill Bonkoski.
Bill Bonkoski took a super shot, part of a father and daughter team. How do you feel, Bill? Is it a good shot for you?
Well, I don't know. I'm still thinking about it. I just think I just had some oil running out of the passive cover.
I'll tell you, on the shot, about halfway through, we noticed the engine sound like it was breaking up a little bit on you, but you stayed after it. How come you did that?
Well, just trying to get it down there. We just got to lean it up a little bit more.
We get ready in a moment. His daughter will be coming doing battle for the red man point. Back upstairs to you.
All right, so we have established a new leader in Bill Bonkoski, but here has got to be one of the favorites, Wayne Roush, a regular Redman TNT circuit driver, and this has got to be a crowd favorite too, right, Army?
Yeah, Roush out here on the West Coast, a lot of the pullers from this part of the country would love to get a hold of him, and he's going to be a tough one to beat. He brought two bullets with him. Looks like he's having a little bit of problem as one of the cylinders is not firing at all on the Chrysler Hemi engine.
Maybe a problem for him, but not for the crowd. As you can see, they are getting into Wayne Roush's pull at 233 1-inch. That is not a bad distance, considering he had some problems.
A lot of the fellas taking a shot at him. They knew he was going to be tough. He'll bump up into that number one spot.
And, of course, Wayne is going to be back with another vehicle in just a few minutes. And coming to the line next, though, is going to be John Shipman out of Turley, California. You are going to love this machine. It is called Temporary Insanity, and this looks more like a funny car dragster than a puller.
Exactly what it is. The old funny car body comes out. However, the front wheel wells are enclosed here. Aerodynamics not important. This is purely for looks. Gets a good roll, dials in the horsepower, a little bit lighter on the nose. Super ground speed, front end starting to come up. He's going after Roush.
And he pulls off to the left side. A great, great pull. New leader, 236 and 6. But Wayne Roush will be back with another pull. And Army is down there to ask him about his next pull now.
Wayne Roush out of Ohio. This is going to be the second shot in the yellow vehicle. You just ran the red truck, went to the number one spot. Did you learn anything from that pass?
It didn't look like I learned too much from the first pass. I was quite heavy with that one, and I should have done better than that.
Well, have you made any change on the yellow 23 that we're leaning on here in order to make this next pass?
Yes, we moved about 80 pounds from the front to the back on this one.
All right, so Wayne Roush is going to bring his second vehicle to the line, try to retake the lead. This is the yellow Model T, Army.
Went to the number one spot a moment ago, bumped out of that spot. What is telling us? The track seems to be getting a little bit better. Welsh told us he had to move some weight in order to put the horsepower to the track.
And look at the crowd stand for this pull.
It looks like he might be going back on top of this thing, Richard.
He is going to take the lead, and the crowd absolutely loves Wayne Roush, the only regular Redman TNT circuit puller running in this competition. Look at that distance, 275 feet plus. And earlier today, you, Army, spent the afternoon with Wayne Roush and talked to him about the competition coming out here to Spartan Stadium in San Jose, California. Let's go to the interview now.
Wayne Roush out of Dublin, Ohio, a long way from home, from Dublin, Ohio to San Jose, California. Wayne, we noticed a tremendous number of Chrysler-powered vehicles on the West Coast. Now, back east, the Arius engine, the Rodec engine, the Chevrolet seem to be dominating. However, out here, the Chrysler seems to be making an awful lot of horsepower. Explain that to us.
As you know, the Chrysler, the KB, is an awfully good motor. And, of course, it's made out here, as are the Arius and all. The Chryslers are good motors. I don't know why the Arius and the Fords are so much more popular out east.
Wayne, could you give us a little bit of information about your background and education? Also, how in the world you got involved in this sport?
Army, I've always enjoyed motorsports, and I'm committed to pulling. I got involved in sort of a small way with the mini-modified tractor, which we did as a family. And now with the two trucks, it's all I do, essentially, and I'm committed to it, to do the best I can and to do the best I can for pulling as a sport. As you indicated, I was on the faculty at Ohio State for 14 years, which is dairy cows. I was in teaching that, which has nothing to do with motors. So, you know, that's been interesting because this is something different. It's something that I didn't have any expertise in, and so it's been a challenge, which I think is important to all of us in life.
When the first year a national championship was given in the super modified two-wheel drive category in the NTPA circuit, Wayne Roush was your first ever national champion in the super modified two-wheel drives. Academia is in professional pulling.
Well, you're absolutely right, Darmy. As a matter of fact, Wayne Roush has a PhD, so it's Dr. Wayne Roush. And even though he's the leader, here's the guy that's going to try to knock him off the throne. He's a local favorite. This is Rick Garrett driving another sharp-looking vehicle, Army.
Yeah, based out of Riverside, California, Garrett spots the sled a little bit different. He's working off the launch pad of the starting line, left side. Tremendous ground speed at half track. The crowd's really getting involved in it. These California pullers really work the crowd.
I'll tell you what, they pick out their fan favorites. Rick Garrett has got to be one of the favorites. Now let's see what his distance is. Not that great. It's not good enough to take over first. 252, 10 inches. But the crowd loves Rick Garrett. You see him standing. What you can't see is him holding up a little mascot right now. Let's go trackside with Army Armstrong and Rick Garrett.
Rick Garrett out of Riverside, California, driving a truck, goes by the name of Borrowed Times. A strong shot. Think it's going to keep you up in the top three, Rick?
I don't think so. There's some strong people coming up.
Barrett says it feels good. Rick, what cubic inch engine you're running?
I'm running the smallest one out here, 440 cubic inches.
Small cubic inch engine. However, I think he's going to be good enough to stay in that top five.
All right, coming to the line next is going to be Dennis Morrison, and his brother's going to be pulling tonight.
Yeah, Morrison driving another one of the awesome Dodge-powered vehicles. He wants to go after Roush. East Coast Dodge on top, West Coast Dodge going after him. The weight looks good. Front end starts to lift on him. Tremendous amount of ground speed. Richard, we might have a new leader here.
It certainly looks like with power play, Dennis Morrison takes over the lead, Army.
Dennis Morrison, another one of the Turlock, California pullers, lays down an awesome shot with one of the Dodge-powered vehicles. Dennis, it looks like the Dodge boys are playing hardball tonight. How did that shot feel to you?
It felt real good. The track's biting real well. The truck went fairly straight. I had a little problem. It gripped my butt. The brake around on it real easy. And I got up the end of the checkoff.
Okay, now you have another Dodge-powered truck that'll be coming out a little bit later. Where did you draw on the field with that truck? And will you make any changes with the second truck of what you've learned for this first shot?
I don't think so. I think we're going to leave the other one alone, too. My brother drives the other one. He basically takes care of that truck, and I think he'll probably leave it alone.
So once again, the Dodge boys playing hardball in California on a Redman Tour.
So Dennis Morrison is our new leader. His brother Twain will be pulling later on. And you know the Redman TNT Pulling Series is truly a family sport. We've already told you about the father-daughter team here tonight. But when we return, a housewife from Idaho will be driving two vehicles as the West Coast women go behind the wheel.
The carpet collection is one of the
ESPN's NASCAR season begins with the Good Wrench 500, Sunday afternoon at noon Eastern, live on ESPN.
Welcome back to San Jose, California, everybody, where Dennis Marson just took the pulling lead with a pull of 278-plus feet. And Army, coming up next is an interesting tale. It's going to be our first lady puller.
Yeah, she'll be driving a vehicle, Barbara Casel. She's out of Idaho. She's driving a vehicle she normally does not drive. This vehicle normally is driven by her husband. He's not able to come to the event. He's a farmer. He had to stay in the field. Barb brought the vehicle over. Let's see what she can do with it, Richard.
Now, Barbara is 30 years old. Besides being a housewife, she's a dairy farmer, and she's off the line in good shape.
Has a good run going. Now she downs the horsepower and looking real good. She's been on a tour quite a while. Running a little bit light. Starts the sky on her just a little bit, Richard. She's looking awfully strong this evening.
And the crowd recognizes it. They either love Barbara or they love the car. Army, let's go down and talk to Barbara Casel after a pull of 264.
Barbara Casel out of Idaho doing a super job tonight driving hubby's truck. He had to stay home. Aaron Balkin farming. He had to do some planting. His wife brought the vehicle over. How do you feel about your shot?
I'm disappointed. I had to stand on the brakes. I had a heck of a good shot going, but about the 125-foot mark, I had to just stand on it.
Well, now, this is your husband's vehicle, like we were telling him a moment ago. You're going to be coming up driving your truck a little bit later, known as Pete's Dragon. Did you learn anything on this shot that'll help you a little bit later?
Yeah, I'll have my truck set up right.
She'll be back chasing the boys in California on the Red Man Tour.
And Army, we were talking about the combinations of relatives running here tonight. This is Dwayne Marson, the brother of the current leader, and he's driving Black Attack.
The Black Attack, an identical appearing vehicle to the current leader. Now, his brother sits on top of this thing at a 278. There will be no brotherly love here. Dwayne is going to go after him. He rolls on the sled, right hand on the throttle. He'll pull the trigger right about now. He's looking good. The front end a little bit light, starts to sky a little bit on him. Richard, he's going flat for his brother in that number one spot.
And watch him work the steering wheel as the crowd is working their way to their feet. Dwayne Marson, I think he's got enough. He does. He's the new leader. Let's go down and talk to him with Army Armstrong.
Well, we said it a moment ago, the Dodge boys are playing hardball. Dwayne Morrison comes out. His brother was our previous leader. He immediately goes to the head of the field. Dwayne, were you aware right at the end of the pull that you lost a blower belt on the truck?
Yeah, I could tell it started, the motor started to lay down a little bit, but I knew I was close to the end, and I didn't want to get out of the throttle. I wanted to stay in it and see if I could get it all the way out.
Well, the Morrison boys, the brothers of pair, come in, are set 1-2 on the Red Man Tour. Right at the top of the pile in California, the Dodges once again looking awfully strong this evening.
So we have established a new leader. Dwayne Marson has taken over the lead, and that brings to the line Bob Borba, driving the one and only.
I'll tell you what, Richard, you talk about quality and class racing operations. The name Bob Borba has to always go to the top of the pile.
And there you see Barbara Casel. She's getting ready. She's going to be making another run in just a few minutes.
Well, Barbara will be back. She said she learned something. Meanwhile, Borba's trying to get a shot out of his new Corvette. Now, he has a sponsorship, one of the few national sponsorships on the tour, of a country out of Australia. Right now, he's trying to lay down a good shot, a class operation out of the Sunshine State. Let's see what he can do.
Now, what's the bouncing going on with the car?
Well, the front end, it doesn't look like he has the weight set exactly right. He's getting a little bit of bounce. The chassis unloaded. I'm sure that he's not going to be happy with his shot. As a matter of fact, we just received word the distance of 247.6. We'll go down in the record book for it.
So, Bob Borba, not a good run. A great-looking car. The crowd got a kick out of it. But here's a lady that's already been on the track once tonight. And she told you she learned something the first time.
Just a moment ago, we saw her adjusting her chassis, setting the air pressure. Pete's dragging the name of the vehicle. Barbara is one to be reckoned with. Beautiful graphics on the side of the vehicle out of the state of Idaho. We told you the story. Her husband not able to be here. She's doing double duty. She believes she can win this thing. All the ladies in the crowd, they're really getting behind her. Let's see what this young lady can do.
Well, of course, Barbara does a triple job. She's not only a pulling driver, she's a housewife and a dairy farmer. So running three full-time professions, let's just enjoy the great pull of Pete's Dragon and Barbara Casel.
Early model Chevrolet sheet metal, late model Chevrolet for horsepower. She looks like she's got
the crowd.
Awesome.
The crowd is on their feet for Barbara Casel. Oh, she has got a full pull on him. Almost going into the wall off the racetrack. A full pull for Barbara Casel.
Just a moment ago, she said she learned something. She proved it to all the fellas out there. Right at the end of the pole, the truck had a tendency to hook a little bit to the left. I believe she was staying off the brakes as long as she could. The hook was a result of hitting a soft spot in the track. The people in California are going crazy, and she calls for a tow tractor.
You run down to talk to Barbara. There you see her. She is a jubilant lady. Let's go down now. Arby is congratulating her. Let's hear what Barbara Basil has to say.
Well, I tell you what, ladies and gentlemen, Barbara Carzo out of Idaho comes up, lays down a shot, pulls it almost out of the ballpark. You got to be feeling great, kid.
Just wonderful.
How did it feel? You had a tremendous amount of ground speed coming down the track. How did it feel to you? Did you know you had this thing?
I knew I was going to kiss the wall.
I tell you, the crowd behind us, they were going crazy. Looks like a young lady may take the first win in the two-wheel super category on the West Coast on the Red Man Tour. Best of luck to you, Barb.
So three trucks to go. Will one of them join Barbara at a pull-off?
This alarm clock telephone.
They just witnessed. And that was a full pull by Barbara Kazel. And you see her right there, a happy lady. And there's another lady, though, that's about to take to the track. And Army Armstrong is going to go down trackside with her right now.
Kathy Bonkowski, she'll be doing battle a little bit later. We just talked to her father. He said he felt he made a good run. Did you learn anything from watching your father's run, Kathy?
Yeah, I guess. Just not come out a little bit harder than he did.
Are you going to be doing any difference with the weight? You going to be moving any weight around in the vehicle?
I don't think so. I think we got it set pretty much good for this track.
Sounds good. So the Arizona father and daughter team, let's see what's going to happen. She'll be coming out in just a few minutes.
All right, so we'll look forward to seeing Kathy pull, but right now it's Terry Albers out of Ventura, California, and the oil patch puller number two, and this is an interesting rig, Army.
I tell you, Terry's been one of the strong pullers on the West Coast for many years. He's made a major change. He switched from Chevrolet to an Arias all-aluminum engine. Let's see if it's going to make a difference on him. He starts to dial the horsepower. It looks a little bit heavy on the nose. He now starts to power it up. He's got some good ground speed, Richard. It looks like he's going to be able to pull up into the top of the field.
Oh, the crowd thought he might have had a full pull. You see him standing 285 foot 3 inches. That is good enough to put him into third place now, Army.
Well, I tell you, Terry's been a strong runner.
And here's the lady that we have been waiting to see, Kathy Bonkowski. What a story. 19 years old. Her father ran earlier, so she is going to have a little bit of an edge here.
Her father just helped her back the vehicle up. He walked away from it. She spots the sled all the way to the left side of the track. She's kind of going what we call over into no man's land, working a cushion on the left side. Hope she has her weight right. She's talked to her father. The crowd behind her, the young lady out of Arizona, rolls onto the throttle, pulls the trigger on a big supercharged Chevrolet Corvette, and starts her run.
God's thunder is on the move, and the crowd is loving it, but she is going to bog down, it looks like, early in this pull.
Horsepower stayed up on the engine. Looks like she may have missed the weight just a little bit.
All right, Kathy Bonkowski, only 239 feet. She loves the crowd. The crowd loves her. God's thunder. Let's go down and talk with Kathy.
Well, Kathy, how do you feel? All the way over from Arizona. You laid down a shot. Are you satisfied with it?
I'm pretty satisfied. At least I didn't break.
Well, if you had it to do over again, would you make any kind of changes as far as moving your weight or anything?
I don't think so. I think the weight was good. Just ran out of power. That's about it.
Well, I tell you what, the ladies got a lot to be proud of this evening in California. First stop on a Red Man Tour. We've got a young lady in the lead. Another time, another day, you'll be there.
Can I thank TNT and Red Man and my new husband and my mother and father?
All right. Perfect young lady out of Arizona. Kathy, you'll be back another day. Thank you.
All right, so now the stage is set, and it's all up to this gentleman, Ron Melling, out of Sanger, California, driving Falconette. He's the last hope of anyone to catch Barbara Castle for a pull-off tonight.
Barb sits on top of the pile. Ron's got nothing to lose. Drew at the bottom of the field, a little one-on-one. It's going to be the guys going against the girls. It's who's going to take the win on the first West Coast stop of the TNT Red Man Tour. He starts his roll.
And the green lights are out, and he is making the pull. There's sparks coming out from under there.
Looks like he's really got a run going, Richard. Clutch explosion, I believe. Let me go check it out.
All right, you saw the sparks fly out of Ron Melling's Falconette. He only gets a distance of 198 feet and 8 inches. Army Armstrong, thinking the clutch has gone out on it, he's gone down trackside, checking things out with Ron Melling. What a tough break for him, but what great luck for Barbara Castle, the only one to pull it off tonight. A full pull tonight for Barbara, and she is going to be our winner tonight in the Redman TNT Truck and Tractor Pulling Challenge in San Jose. And we're going to come back in just a minute with another look at that winning pull by Barbara. Plus, we're going to run down the top five finishers tonight. After a great show tonight, you see a majority of the crowd sticking around to watch an exhibition from that guy, a monster tank. And it would be a good time right now, Army, for us to run down the final five. And in fifth place tonight was a guy that came in with a lot of expectations, Wayne Roush.
Wayne comes over from the East Coast, a national points contender, really running some tough competition. He's going to be tickled to death for that fifth place finish.
And fourth place tonight went to one of the brother acts, Dennis Marson.
Dennis teams up with his brother to make the Chrysler horsepower look even awesome on his cool California evening.
And Terry Albers takes third.
Albers switched over from the Chevrolet camp to the Aries aluminum engine. Good showing.
And second to the other brother, Dwayne Marson.
The other half of the Marson brothers, what can we say? They're making horsepower.
But what can you say about the winner tonight, Barbara Castle? We're going to take another look at that terrific full pull by Barbara Castle.
Barbara made two runs this evening. The first run, she told us she felt she had learned something. They went back and a lot of chassis work. She looks to be just about ideal on her weight. You'll notice the front wheels barely leave the ground. She almost tippy-toes the front end of this early model Chevrolet all the way down. Dows the horsepower in just right, very patient. Let the track come to her. A little bit of chassis unload. She goes on the throttle, puts the horsepower back in the track, develops a tremendous amount of ground speed, and the people in San Jose, California go crazy for the first victor on the West Coast Tour.
Now, what I find interesting, you see the tires, they veer now to the left, and she almost goes right into the wall.
She said earlier she was trying to stay off the brake as much as she could. The reason it went left, there was a soft spot in the track to the left. When she hit it, it pulled her over.
All right, a great full pull by your winner tonight. That is Barbara Castle. She is only 30 years old, a housewife, and a dairy farmer out of Idaho. And overall tonight, it was a great show by everybody.
We'd like to thank Zizek Motorsports for bringing the TNT Tour to the West Coast.
And, of course, Army, we're going to be back here again, hopefully, in the near future, the great folks of San Jose. On behalf of Army Armstrong, I'm Richard Leak, saying Godspeed on the tracks of your life.
Join us next time for Power Tracks, the most powerful sport on earth. Brought to you by...